Very good morning to one and all. We have started the lesson number 8, that is skeletal system. We have already discussed about the skeletal systems. What is meant by the skeletal system? Skeletal system is nothing but it is consists of bones. Am I right? It consists of bones which gives the shape and support to our body. Am I right? It gives shape and support to our body. The skeletal system gives shape and support to our body. It protects our delicate organ. Am I right? And also we have discussed the main types of the skeletal system. Can you just recall which type of the skeletal system we have learned? Can you just tell me? Yes. We have learned about the skull, which protects our brain, How many bones does the skull has? Yes, 22 bones. How many total bones does the skull has? 22 bones. And it is a fixed. These bones are fixed except your lower jaw. Which help us for eating. Yes or no? For speaking. Then the next part we have learned about a backbone. How many small bones does the backbone have? Yes, 33 bones. How many? 33 bones. And it protects our delicate organ, spinal cord. Protect our spinal cord. Then we have discussed about the rib cage. Where it is? Where it is found? It is found in the chest. And it protects our heart and lungs. Now how many pairs does the rib has? Yes, 12 pairs. How many pairs it has? 12 pairs. Then the last main part, do you remember which part we have learned? Yes, limbs. It is also called as it is present in our arm and leg. This type of the bones are present in our arm and leg. That is forelimb and hind limb. We call them as a forelimb and hind limb. Then, which is in this we have learned limbs. We have learned about the which is the longest bone in our body. Yes, femur is the longest bone in our body, which is present in our leg. Are you getting? Then we have discussed about the function of skeletal system. What is the function of skeletal system? Am I right? Now, today we are going to discuss the new point. Now see, if you might have, you have seen the skeletal system in the last video. Am I right? So, if you will see the skeletal system, it consists of the number of bones. Yes? Now, these bones are, if you want to join this bone, these are the different types of the bones which are found. If you will see skull, backbone, if you will make them separate, then we have, if they are in our body. Yes or no? They are in our body. Now, we have to join them together. Yes? We have to meet them together. Now, if you will see the skeletal system, the bones are joined. Yes or no? So, where the bones meet each other, that is called as a joint. For example, now see, these are some papers. Yes? Now, I want this paper to be together in the file. So, I have joined with this clip. Yes or no? I have joined with this clip. Am I right? So, these bones are, these papers are together. I have joined this with a clip. So these papers are together. I have collected in the one file. Am I right? So, similarly, the skeletal system should be joined with the particular gum. Now, for example, if you are doing any craft activity, yes or no? You might be doing the different types of the craft activity. In that, you have to join the particular paper, or if you want to join a particular stick, Then what do you use? Yes, you use Fevicol or a gum. Yes or no? So like that, we can't use the gum or Fevicol to join our bones. Here we use a strong tissue that is called as a ligament. What we use? Strong tissue which is called as a ligament. What it is called? It is called as a ligament. The bones are joined with a strong tissue that is ligament. That is what it is called? Ligaments. These bones, see, these are, here are two bones and here is one bone, am I right? So these bones are joined by a strong tissue that is called as a ligament. Are you getting this? Now, if you will see, these joints are mainly classified into two types, movable and immovable. The joints are mainly classified into two types, that is movable and immovable joints. Now, movable joint is what? Which can be moved, the joints which can be moved. For example, if you take your hand, it is moving continuously, yes or no? Legs, they are moving continuously. Means the joints or the bones which can move, they are called as a movable joints and immovable. For example, your skull, whether it is moving? No, it is fixed. Am I right? So, it is immovable joint. It is immovable joint. Now, these movable joints are further classified into four main types. So, these are the four types. The movable joints are classified into four types. The first is ball and socket joint. The first is ball and socket joint. See, this is a ball and socket joint. It is present in our hand or it is present in the shoulder. It is present in shoulder and in the hip. So, this here is a ball and here this is a socket. Okay? And this ball and socket joint, it can move in all the directions. Your hand can move in all the directions. Yes or no? Yes, rotate your hand. Yes, it can move in all the directions. So, ball and socket joint can move in all the directions. And it is present in our shoulder and hip. It is present in our shoulder and hip. Yes. The next type of the joint is hinge joint. This is present, ball and socket joint is present in our shoulder and hip and it can move in all the direction. The next is hinge joint. Now, if you might have seen the door, have you seen the door? Yes. Now, you can see that hinge which is present in the door like that. Similarly, the hinge joint is there in our elbow and knee. Elbow and knee. Which can move in one direction. Which can move in one direction. That is up, down. Up, down. It is present in elbow, knee and fingers. Where it is present? The hinge joint is present in our elbow, knee and finger. Which can move in only in one direction. That is up, down. Are you getting? So, hinge joint can move in one direction. The next type of the movable joint is pyroid joint, which is present in our neck, which is present in the neck. The skull is totally attached to the backbone, yes or no? So which joint is there between this? It is pyroid joint. It helps to move our neck up, down and side. This joint helps us to move up, down and side. The which joint is present in the neck? Pyroid joint. Which joint is present? Pyroid joint, which is present in our neck. Then the next is gliding joint. Gliding joint is present in our ankle, which moves only slightly. Here, the movement of the bones are slightly. They can move only small, means they can move. They can just move slightly. Are you getting? So this type of the joint which is present in the ankle, that is called as a gliding joint. So these are the four main types of joint. Actually activity, the joints are classified mainly into the two types, that is movable and immovable. Immovable joint, where it is present, it is in the skull, it is fixed. While movable joints are classified into the four main types, that is ball and socket, hinge joint, fiber joint and gliding joint. Ball and socket joint is present in our shoulder and hip. Hinge joint is present in our elbow, knee and finger. Fiber joint is present in our neck, while gliding joint is present in our ankle. It is there in the ankle. Are you getting this? So these are the types of joint. I hope you have understood it. And today's work will be that you have to draw this chart in your science notebook and write about the ball and socket, hinge joint, fiber joint and gliding joint in your science notebook, where they are present and how do they move. Okay, thank you.